Hey guys, I'm going to show you how you can use this small piece of software called Rufus, which you can easily download from the web for free. It can be used to make a bootable USB drive. Now, I have my USB drive plugged into this system and I have downloaded the latest version of Rufus software. I also have Windows ISO image saved in this system. So without taking so much of your time, let's get into the business. I'm locating my Rufus software. Rufus is R-U-F-U-S. You can simply Google for it and download it. So it's here. I'm opening this as administrator. Yes. So this is the software. Like I said, my USB drive is already plugged into this system, so this software has found it. You can see here in the status bar it says one device found, and the device label is the label and the letter, assigned letter, and its capacity. All details are shown here. So this is the device. Say you had several USB drives plugged into the system, you will want to select which USB you are going to use for this. And this is a 16 GB USB drive, and you need to select the ISO image here. So click on select and go to your computer and locate wherever your file is. So my ISO file is this one. It's Windows 10 Pro ISO file. Opening it. Now you have an image option here. You have to select standard Windows installation, and partition scheme should be GPT, because GPT partition scheme is the one that is going with UEFI target system. You have advanced drive properties here. You don't really need to worry about that. And you can add a volume label here. So I'm just typing in 1909, that is the version. And the file system should be FAT32 by default, and the cluster size is 8192 bytes by default. Yeah, okay. Everything should be like this. Now you can simply click start. Now you should get a warning that all the data will on the USB drive will be lost. So you should get a blank USB drive. You shouldn't have important data in it, because all will be deleted, the drive will be formatted. So I'm this one, it says all data on device Windows 10 T 16 GB will be destroyed. To continue with this operation, click OK. To quit, click cancel. I'm pressing OK and the process starts now. So this should take about 9 minutes. It's going faster. You can see it's a very small software, but doing a huge job here. You have some application settings and a log. You can view the log here, and application settings here. They don't seem to work. Only this seems to be the one active. I'll leave it like this. So right after this bootable disk generation, what you have to do is you just leave the USB drive plugged in and restart the system. Go into system BIOS and select boot option as the USB drive. Windows, when you are installing Windows on your system with the USB drive, that means using the UEFI system, the particular drive partition should have the partition scheme GPT. That is actually another video here. I will link that particular video at the end of this video. You can simply, that's also a simple command prompt process. You can use dispart command prompt in order to make a particular partition of your hard drive or SSD GPT drive. leave the USB stick plugged in and restart your system. Go into your BIOS and select boot option as USB drive and restart your system, and it will boot using this Windows installation, so you can install brand new Windows on your system. I'll make another video showing you how you can use this part command prompt to convert a particular drive or drive partition to a GPT partition scheme from MBR to GPT. So we are done. It's 9 minutes. This software has done a pretty good job making my USB drive a bootable one. So if you find this video useful, please like it, comment if you want to share your thoughts. If you think in future you will need my channel updates, please subscribe, and thanks for watching.